So here we have the GSW hot water tank. My heater had the three lights blinking down here on the indication mechanism, indicating that there was a pressure sensor failure. Now the easiest thing to do here, if you want to save a bunch of money before calling a technician, is there was three items that they had me check out and try out first. One is to make sure your vent here is fully clear of any debris and such. So that means checking it outside at the exhaust, making sure there's no bird's nest in there or anything, branches, leaves blocking it. The next part is to just check this mechanism here. You have this hose here, and this right here is your pressure sensor in there. So basically what happens is the fan will turn on, it'll start blowing air out there, and this item here is going to create a negative vacuum this way, which will flick a switch at this mechanism here, create an electrical current saying that, yeah, everything's okay, there's air flowing, and we're not going to poison everyone with carbon monoxide in the house. If that switch fails, which it did in this case, the engine, the motor won't turn on, the heat won't heat up, the water's going to stay cold. So what you want to do is remove this hose here and just check it. In some videos there was a water in this hose which was blocking it. So you take this off, make sure that you do this, water comes out. Next you want to check in this thing here. You can remove it with these screws here and check inside. Please make sure that your power's off to this mechanism first so you don't electrocute yourself. So check in here too. You can put a small piece of paper clip in there to make sure there's no debris first. Take a look out. And what my problem was here is this area here. So there's this nipple here that goes into the motor. And if you looked in there, it looked clear. What I did was just blow into that. So I blew into that, cleared any debris that was in there, and my motor started up again, and everything was working fine. So those are some easy steps, three easy steps to make sure that everything's functioning properly with that switch before you go call a technician and spend a bunch of money to fix this thing. Hope this helped you.